Praise the Lord. I just want to tender an apology for the break in transmission. So we have to switch our system to another one. Praise the Lord. Yes. Once again, I want to appreciate God. It's a God of mercy. Praise the Lord. Today, by the grace of God, we look at the word with the title which says, "Where is your God? Where is your God?" And our Bible passage for this meeting is going to be taken in the book of Psalm 42. I'm going to read from verse 3 through 5. I want to appreciate God, and I want to thank you guys for coming once again. I'm sorry for the loss in transmission. It was the bad, and we have to switch our equipment. Praise the Lord. I want to appreciate Pastor Lauren Shogo. I want to appreciate my brother Laminu Shotami. God bless you all. I want to appreciate you. God bless you all. Our Bible passage is taken in the book of Psalm 42. I'm going to read from verse 3 through 5. Psalm 42, I read from verse 3 through 5, which says thus, "My tears have been my food, day and night. Why people say to me all day long, 'Where is your God?' These things I remember as I pour out my soul, how I used to go to the house of God under the protection of the Mighty One, with shout of joy and praise among the festive throng." Verse 5, "Why, my soul, are you downcast? Why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise Him, my Savior and my God." Praise the Lord. "My soul, why thou downcast within?" Then you look at the title which says, "Where is your God?" This question of "Where is your God?" It is a kind of statement. It's not a fallacy. It's not a question that's just being asked anyhow. The above statement is not just a statement of rhetorical question. It is a deep and demanding. Any situation or challenges that is asking, "Where is your God?" Two things might likely happen here. Maybe because of a situation that one is passing through, a challenge that seems to overwhelm one, then people are tended to ask, "Where is your God?" You look at the life of Job. Job is a classic example. While Job was passing through the trial of life, so to the extent his friends, they are approaching himself, he was lost. Then the second aspect of it, where such a question could come from, is when you are praising God, when you are in deep praising God, serious one. So you can just observe by saying, "God, where is you? Where is my God? You are just too mighty." You know, just appreciate God. Situation prevailing around us may cause people to pose such a question to us, asking us, "Where is our God?" When situations seem to be defiling our solution. So people, they intended to ask you. They may not ask you directly, but when you are not portrayed the imagery of God, because God says you are created in His own image, and therefore you must manifest in the image of God. Everything concerning you, maybe your health, your finance, your marriage, your business, they are nosediving, your ministry, they are not doing well. There is tendency that people may ask, "Where is your God? Where is your God?" There are certain questions that could be given to such are questions. But according to the passage we've just read, which is Psalm 42, verse 3 to 5, the sons of Korah in their song, you know, the song of Psalm, in that particular page, they raised the question of hope and fills with lament when such was ongoing. So the sons of Korah, in the course of their song in Psalm 42, they raised that lamentation question: "Where is our God and what is the hope ahead of us?" They said, "My tears have been my food day and night. Why people say to me all day long, 'Where is your God?'" Because of what he was passing through, because of what he was going around him. So people, they were now asking, "Really, do you have God? Is your God alive?" I don't know a situation where you find yourself. I don't know what is happening. Maybe your marriage is of age, it's years, and yet the joy of marriage is not forthcoming. People, they might indirectly challenge you, "Where is your God?" You don't need to lose a sleep in it, because your God is alive. Praise the Lord. According to Psalm 115, verse 2 through 3, "Our God is in the heavens. He does all that He pleases Him. If any question of such is coming from, I mean, you tell them our God is in heaven and he does all that he pleases him. So our God is in heaven, he does whatever that pleases him and no one can query him. His authority is final. It is God raised in his throne and doing things according to him, to his everlasting wisdom, according to his infinity wisdom and good plan. God does not just do anything anyhow. He has a plan and he does it at will. So his infinite wisdom is immeasurable. He does not have the beginning and he can never have an end. According to Jeremiah chapter 2, well, because of time, time is not on our side, so therefore I won't be able to read it. But you can just note there. But I'm going to paraphrase what's written there. Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 7 to 8. God is in the same place he used to be when he gave you thousands of good days and nights, when things are rosy and they're pleasurable. Praise the Lord. When such a question comes forth, you know, you can ask, where is your God? You tell them your God used to be where he is. You know, your God used to be. Because many of us, it is when we are passing through turbulence period in life that we remember our God. And once there is a solution, we don't have any problem. We are enjoying things around us. We only pocket our God at our back pocket. We don't remember him. So your God is where you kept him. It is when you wake up to realization that you need your God. Your God will answer for you. Number 3. According to Revelation chapter 2, verse 10, the Bible says, do not fear what you are about to suffer. Revelation chapter 2, verse 7, he said, do not fear of what you are going to suffer. Because why? Therefore, your tempter is going to cast some of you into prison for a good 10 days. You check it out. So, in the course of trial, when you are incarcerated, your God is alive. Your God does not slumber. Your God is waiting. Your God is doing that wonderful things in your life. Praise the Lord. So you don't need to lose any sleep because your God is very much alive.
Your God is alive. Your God does not slumber.
Second Timothy chapter 4 verse 17, the Bible telling us, say, but the Lord stood by me and strengthened me. So when people ask you, where is your God? You tell them, according to 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 17, the Lord stood by me and he gave me strength. He encouraged you. It is as a result of an encouragement from God that enables you to be alive, to do certain things. You don't need to lose any sleep. In as much that you are alive, you are not dead yet. You have every reason to answer them that my God is alive. My God is testing me, and he will come out to save me at the perfect time. When you are going through any trial, challenges in life, know that you are just undergoing a test of time. God is going to rise in your defense. He will bring out the Joker to defend you at the right time. You know, according to the book of Micah chapter 7, verse 8. I would love us to read that particular chapter of the Bible. Micah chapter 7. The Bible is telling us, you know, when people ask you, where is your God? You have every reason to answer them that your God is alive. Your God is working in you. Your God is a God of perfection. Your God can never let you down. Micah chapter 7, we read from verse 8 and through 10. I read from here. The Bible says, do not gloat over me, my enemy. Though I have fallen, I will rise. Though I sit in darkness, the Lord will be my light. Verse 9. Because I have sinned against him, I will bear the Lord's wrath until he pleads my case and uphold my cause. He will bring me out into the light. I will see his righteousness. Verse 10. Then my enemy will see it and will be covered with shame. She who said to me, where is the Lord your God? My eyes will see her good downfall. Even now, she will be trampled underfoot like mire in the street. Praise the Lord. When people ask you, where is your God? You tell them, don't rejoice over me. Don't rejoice over my situation. I don't know the prevailing situation around you. Tell your enemy they should not rejoice over your calamity or situation, because your God is always there to plead your cause. And at the right time, the Lord is going to bring forth your testimony. People, they will see God is preparing you for the day of vengeance, because your God is a God of vengeance, and is going to avenge over your enemy. As many that are mocking you because of your situation, your finance is not doing well, maybe your business is nosediving, so they are now mocking you, they are mocking your God. You will tell them that at the right time, God is going to come out. He will bring me to the limelight, because he's a God of light. So you don't need to be downcasted. Don't allow any situation to challenge your God. Don't allow any situation to query your God. An attempt of any situation to query your God. Tell that situation that I have a bigger God. And at the right time, I know my God will answer for me. Praise the Lord. Then another thing, God is right there in your front. Many of us, we are not take cognizance. God is everywhere, is ever present, is the Alpha, is the Omega. God does not go anywhere. The psalmist says, our God, I look up unto the hill. Where cometh my help? My help comes from God Almighty. God that never slumber, he never sleep, he never embark on a journey. If anyone tells you, tell them, my God is right in front of me. My God is with me. The Bible says, in the beginning was the Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. So your God, the word you have spoken is God. The word that you are hearing is word. So your God is ever present. Nothing can take him away from you. When there was a challenge with Elijah, Elijah ran for his dear life. At a point in time, he thought everything was over. He could not hear anything. But at the right time, God appeared in form of a wind. So when when he saw the white wind, he thought God was coming out from there. But God was not there. You know, at a point in time, there was a kind of fire. He thought God was there. But at last, God now spoke in a very soft tongue. So your God is alive. Your God is in the front. It does not matter. Tell your situation, I have a bigger God. So my God does not embark on a journey. My God does not sleep. My God does not even, he does not lose sleep over anything, because he's the creator of the whole universe. He's seated in heaven and does whatever that pleases him. At the right time, he will not allow enemy to triumph over me. At the right time, he's going to rise in my defense. Like we read in the book of Micah. The Micah says, he said, do not gloat over me, my enemy. Though I have fallen, I am going to rise again. Tell your situation. Have you written or attempted an examination first time, second time, but you could not? The beautiful things about life is that it's always good to experience failure in life. If you don't fail in life, then you will not strategize. So if things are just going rosy, 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 then you have to be very careful. Such a situation may not long last. It's just like a dripping water. If a water is dripping, then there is tendency that it's going to last long, but at a tap that you just open that is overflowing, within a shorter period of time, the water in the tank or in the reservoir is going to be exhausted. So when you are going through situation in life, know that God is around. God is involved. At the right time, he's going to bail you. At the right time, he's going to deliver you. At the right time, he's going to upgrade you. He will take you to the next level, because your God is a God of mercy. He said, you have mercy unto those who will have mercy. Because you are a candidate of mercy, that's the reason why you are alive. And the moment you are alive, you know all hope is not lost. After all, the Bible says, a living dog is better than dead lion. So because you are not dead, you are alive. So you have hope of better tomorrow. Tell your situation that I don't care. My God is alive. So whosoever that is asking after your God, tell them my God is alive. Your situation, your finances, God is alive. I don't know about your marriage. Maybe you have been trusting God for the fruit of the womb. Tell your situation that according to the word of God concerning me, I shall not be barren. The Bible says that I shall not be barren in the house of the Lord. So if that should be the case, it's applicable to me and members of my family. So I can never be barren. That is not the plan of God for my life, for my marriage. God instituted that marriage. I must bear my own fruit, and I'm going to see it. My fruit will be abound. So tell your situation, my God is alive. You don't need to ask after my God. Praise the Lord. We rejoice. According to Romans chapter 5 verse 3, we rejoice in our suffering, knowing that suffering produces endurance. So if you are going through any situation, rejoice. Don't be mad at your God. Don't be mad at your God. Say, I know, because at the end of the day, if I'm able to persevere, I'm going to come out in flying color. I'm going to come out, you know, like the gold that you wear. No, I don't know the kind of gold. I don't know the weight. But this gold you are seeing, it does not just come down from, it passes through fire. It is after rigorous beating here, panel beating, heating and heating, that is now coming out shining. So when you endure the persecution or the trial, then you are going to come out brighter. The whole world, they will see. You will not be a showcase of God Almighty. God will not be boast and be proud of you. He'll be able to tell you that I am God of this and God of that. If God can be boast enough and say, look, I am God of Abraham, I am God of Isaac, and I'm God of Jacob. Why? Because these are the people, their earthly assignment, they were able to fulfill all obligation. That's why us and them. And I believe God for you, that whatever situation that's prevailing around you, wherever the country where you are residing, in your family, you are going to come out triumphantly in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In as much that you have hope, is it your place of work that some people along the line, they are tormenting you? No, they are now a thorn in your flesh. Don't lose any sleep. Just tell them, you have today, but I know my God will arise for me tomorrow. Because if you remember what happened on Mount Carmel, you know, the prophet of Baal, they gang up, they were doing all those things. But in a moment, when God of Elijah, appeared, he appeared in a fire. The fire descended from above and consumed everything. Every situation that seems to defy any solution in your life, today your God will arise in the name of Jesus. If you will trust Jesus Christ, his son, he will turn all your losses into everlasting gain. If you believe in the Son of God, Jesus Christ, what are those losses in your life? What are those losses you have experienced in life? Is it your finances? Is it your ministry? Is it your business? Is it your marriage? Any kind of loss, that Lord will turn them to beautiful gain. You are going to, maximize a serious gain to the extent that you become a celebrity. So shall it be your portion in the name of Jesus. Trust in him today. Accept him. Live in him. And your life will never remain the same. According to Matthew chapter 11 verse 28, he said, come ye all to me, all ye that are labor and with heavy laden. If you go to him, God is going to alleviate your burden. He is going to bear your yoke, because his yoke is lighter. He will make you to enjoy the pleasurable of life. He will allow you to forget yesterday. You know, it's not like as you are rounding up to move to the next segment. It's like a pregnant woman. A pregnant woman, stage one, you know, there's going to what we call a money sickness. Then when he's able to overcome money sickness, she moved to the next stage. The next stage is the period of gestation. Then when it comes, when the delivery period is around, when what we call maybe expected delivery date. So when she moved into that period, she's going to experience what we call severe pain, labor pain. The moment she's experiencing that, she knows that at the very soon, she's going to deliver of a bouncing baby. So, brethren, whatever the situation that's militating against your success or your progress in life, know that God is at work, and God Almighty is going to perfect everything he has done concerning you. So shall it be in the name of Jesus. Brethren, we are going to pray. I want us to move to the next segment, which is our prayer. We are going to pray unto God Almighty. But before we do that, I want you to adore God. Adore your God. Adore your maker. Like I said last week, if a woman knows how to adore her husband, there is a tendency that the husband will go extra mile in order to satisfy or to please her. So if you know how to adore your God who is a faithful God, that God will do something extraordinary for you. He will rise in your defense. God will now introduce himself to your enemy. Don't you know I am the one in charge? He will command the angelic in heaven to rise in your defense. You are going to adore him. You call in all his attributes. Maybe you say after me, maybe to lead you in order to adore God. You will say, you are King of glory. Our Father is a King of glory. He is the Almighty One. There is no one like him. He is the ever greater God. He is the ever greater God. Our God is Creator and the Savior. Our God, you are the Creator and the Savior. You are the Holy God. There is no one as holy as thou, you, Lord. You are the hearer of voices and supplication. You hear the cry and the forces of your people. When we supplicate, you hear us. God, you are my strength. You are our strength, oh God. Without you, we can do nothing. Without you, Lord, we are nothing. Without you, we are as much dead as anything. The Lord is the captain of the Lord of hosts. He is the captain of the Lord of hosts, the angelic in heaven, the host of heaven. Our God is the captain. He is their captain. He ruled in the affairs of men. God, you are the exalted God. Without you, there is no one. There is no king to compare with you. There is no king that to be likened with you. In time of wisdom, in time of knowledge, there is no one. You are our God. Our God is the most fearful and dreadful one. Our God is a consuming fire. You are a consuming fire. Daddy, we bow before thee. We adore you. We worship you. We magnify your holy name. We say you are the higher of the highest. You say you are the greater of the greatest. We say you are the all-sufficient. You are the Jehovah Jireh. You are the Alpha. You are the Omega. You are the beginning. You are the ending. There is none like you. Daddy, we appreciate you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshiped. Amen. Brethren, I want you to take this prayer point. You are going to say, oh Lord, my Father, have mercy and forgive me in any way I might have fallen short of your glory. I want you to know, the Bible says our righteousness is like a filthy garment. So there is no way you cannot lay claim that you are without sin. I want you to ask for mercy. The Bible says, I will have mercy unto those whom I will have mercy. Ask God Almighty, Father, have mercy upon me in any area of my life that I have come short of your glory. Have mercy, O God of heaven. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on my marriage. Have mercy on my ministry. Have mercy on me, O God. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You are going to pray. You are going to ask God. We say, oh Lord, my Father, let there be a divine visitation that will terminate all my years of predicament. You are going to take that prayer point. You say, my Father, let there be a divine visitation. I am yearning for your divine visitation. The visitation that will terminate all my years of predicament. All situations you have passed through in the year past. All the agonies that you have went through, ask God today. Terminate them by divine visitation. You need just a visitation from God. Father, visit us. We charge and we ask for divine visitation in the name of Jesus. God, we ask tonight. After all, your word says, he said, while you were sleeping, the enemy came like a flood, but your spirit did not leave us alone. Daddy, we demand your divine visitation. Visit our family. Visit all my listeners today. Right now, visit them, O Lord, in their situation, at whatever capacity that I bring them on their name. Daddy, I want your visitation. I want you to visit every one of us now. In the name of Jesus Christ, visit every one of us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. We demanded for your divine visitation so that our life will never remain the same, O Lord. That you'll be able to overcome whatever we have passed through in the time past in the name of Jesus. I don't know that situation. I don't know that cancerous situation. I don't know the problem with your health. God, ask God, I need your visitation. If God visits you today, everything will become a story. You become an overcomer. Ask God, I need you. I want you. I demand of you. I want to see you. Visit me aright, O Lord. In the name of Jesus, you visited Abraham. The barrenness in the family became the things of the past. Father, I need your visitation. You visited Israel and you changed his name from Jacob to Israel. His life never remained the same. That day we demanded for your visitation. You visited Gideon and Gideon was empowered. He reigned and delivered his people. Father, we convert your visitation today. Visit us in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The next prayer point we are going to pray, you will ask God, say, Father, turn all my seemingly hopelessness situation around. Every situation around you that seem there's no way, there's no hope again, ask God, turn them around. My hopelessness situation, that it turn them around, O Lord. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you today. Your situation that seem there's no hope ahead, I believe God for you. God will turn them around. You become a celebrity. You become a center of attraction.
People, they will kneel around you. They shall serve your God. You shall feed your enemies in the name of Jesus. Whatever you are passing through, that seems there's no way forward, that you cannot succeed in it, that you cannot make some headway, I pray for you today that the Lord will turn such situation around in the name of Jesus. I don't know your situation. Maybe your womb is no longer there, and they say you cannot be pregnant again. I pray for you today that the Lord will visit your womb, that Lord will turn them around in the name of Jesus. You have attempted examination, you have been writing, you are confused, you don't know what to do again. I pray for you today that the Lord will turn them around. Your hopeless situation, the Lord will turn them around in the name of Jesus. The Lord shall terminate every predicament situation that have made your bow down your head in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Brother, I want to appreciate you. Thank you for coming, most especially Sister Betty. You are welcome. God bless you. I still want us to pray the next prayer point. I want you to tell God Almighty, you know, our God, He said, command ye me concerning my handwork. So He did not say, please. God said, you should give a command. And that's why you are created in the image of God, to be able to give a command. So God said, we should command. And now we are going to pray. You tell God, we say, oh Lord, my Father, bring to an end in my life every form of shame and reproach. Whatever that symbolizes shame and reproach in your life, whatever that symbolizes shame, reproach in your marriage, around you, that your family, that your children, ask God Almighty, God will bring them to an end today in the name of Jesus Christ. Every form of shame, shame in your place of work, you are so indebted hugely. Ask God Almighty, it is a shame on anyone. Because a debtor is a slave to his debt, to his creditor. Ask God Almighty today, every form of shame in my life, Baba, let them come to an end. In the name of Jesus, bring an end to every form of shame in my life, every form of shame in my ministry, every form of shame in my home, every form of shame that is mainly around me, around my marriage, your children, your grandchildren. Ask God Almighty, any kind of situation that is reproaching, ask God Almighty today, Father, arise in the name of Jesus. Put an end to it, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. You are going to pray. You ask God Almighty. You will ask God, say, Father, please prove wrong to all those who have written me off. You have been written off. You have been condemned. They say you cannot make it alive. You are not relevant. People, they look down on you. Remember the title of our meeting today. We say, where is your God? And we try to establish through the word of God where you can now answer. And basically, we took a passage in the book of Psalm 42. We read it from verse 3 through verse 5. Where people, and they ask, the children of Korah, where is your God? So every situation or people that have written you off, that you are mimic, you cannot be relevant in life, you will ask God to prove them wrong. They say in time of academic, you are irrelevant, you are dullard, you cannot contribute anything to the society at large. They have condemned you totally. You are going to ask God today, disappoint all those that have written me off. They said I cannot make any impact in life. Father, disappoint them in the name of Jesus. Your age notwithstanding, our God is the God of ages. He changed not from everlasting to everlasting. The Bible says Moses, at the age of 120 years, his eyes never dim. He was still fishing, doing everything, agile. So God, your age notwithstanding, ask God Almighty, as men that have written you off, Father, arise and disappoint them. Prove them wrong in my life. In the name of Jesus, in the life of your children, they have been written off. They say your children, they cannot be relevant in life. They say your children, they cannot get anywhere. They say you cannot go far in life. Ask God Almighty, disappoint them in the name of Jesus. As many that have condemned me, as many that have boxed me into a corner, as many that say I cannot make it, they say grammatically I am too poor or you are too poor. They say in time of academic, you cannot move forward. Ask God, disappoint them, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. All my mockers, my Father, disappoint them. As many that are getting me afar off, waiting for my downfall, disappoint them, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Finally, brethren, you are going to ask God Almighty. You know, I want to encourage you. All these prayer points, you can revisit them so that you can pray them in your own prayer room. Or maybe at the closet, you can pray, repeat the prayer point. They are very fundamental. And like I kept on telling us, prayer is a communication between the lesser supreme and the higher supreme. And the higher supreme is God that we cannot see. When you communicate, heaven is attentive to you. You remember the life of the king and his own brother. Both of them, they offer offering to God. But Abel's offering was acceptable. Why Cain's were not? Why? Because the frame method of praying unto God. And that's why you are praying as well at this hour. And I believe God Almighty for you, that God will answer you. You will have a testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. It is a matter of faith in action. Then finally, you are going to pray. You ask God. You say, my Father, remove every power that are antagonizing my promotion at all levels. I take it again. We say, my Father, remove every power that are antagonizing my promotions at all levels. I don't know which level your promotion ought to manifest, but there are certain power, there are certain forces in the heavenlies that they did not allow your promotion to be effected. Ask God Almighty today, remove them in the name of Jesus Christ. Every power that is antagonizing, that is blocking my success, that is blocking my progress, that did not want my promotion to come forth, Father, today, remove such power in the name of Jesus. I don't know what that power means. I don't know their source. I don't know where they combine together. But I know the Bible says, who said does and comes to pass without God referencing it? Anyone, any power that can jump together, that they say your promotion will not come, you will not move to the next level, you will not operate at the top, they say you will not get your success, you will not get a divine touch, you will not get a divine lifter. Let God remove some power today in the name of Jesus. I don't care such a power. I don't care who is wielding such a power. All I just know, as many souls that say I will not get there, Father, remove them by fire, by fire. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you today. If Jesus Christ can lead a prayer, Jesus Christ said, he said, all my enemies that say I will not rule over them, bring them under my foot. I pray for you today. All enemies, every power in your household, enemy in your place of work, within your neighborhood, that are antagonizing your promotion. They say you will not get there. They say you will not succeed. They say you have obtained a certificate, but you will not be able to make use of it. They say your place of work, they are going to redundant you. They say they will not allow you to enhance for that promotion. I pray for you today. God shall remove such powers in the name of Jesus. Because the Bible says you are meant for the top. He says you shall lend to the nation. You are not meant to be for beneath. You are not meant to be for below, but you are supposed to be on top forever. I pray for you today that the Lord will remove some power in the name of Jesus in the heavens. The Lord will arise for you. Under Bennett, the Lord will arise for you. In the skies, the Lord will arise for you. Your family problem, the Lord will arise for you. He will remove such, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Is it family connected problem? Is it causes generated in your family? I decree today, in the name of Lord of hosts, that such power that is now fending you from getting to where God intended for your life, I say, let such power be removed today, in the name of Jesus. So shall it be, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, so shall it be, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Brethren, I want to appreciate God for the time we have spent before God. Our God is a faithful God. Don't forget that our theme today is, where is your God? And like I told us, that such a question does not just come anyhow. It is a situation that's defining situation that makes people to ask, where is your God? Or maybe yourself say, God, where is your faith? God, where are you? I believe God for you today, that any situation that is demanding for your God, that Lord will showcase himself, that Lord will prove himself unto such a mighty in the name of Jesus Christ. I want to encourage you that you should go through the prayer points again. I want to encourage you that you can share the video. I want to connect your friend with the video. Let them have the glimpse and let them have the prayer point. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Before I pray for you, and we'll draw the curtain for today's program, I want to implore you that you can just subscribe to our YouTube channel. Just type in Pastor Rufus Ojo or Ojo Rufus on YouTube. It will connect you to the place. Or maybe you go online, just type www.rufusojo.com. So it will take you to my site, Oh, most of those information you need to get there, you will get there. Maybe you want to, we have 24/7 and live stream on internet radio. You can as well go there. You look for www.citadelofmercyradio. It will connect you. It's 24/7 live radio, so that you'll be able to be removed. Time is not aside, but you can get connected there. God bless you as you do so in the mighty name of Jesus. In case you have any contribution, you can just reach out unto us through email citadelofmercy@gmail.com as displayed on the screen, or maybe you want to send through mercyplusministry.com, www.mercyplusministries.com. God bless you as you do so in the name of Jesus. My Father, I pray for your people today according to the anointing that functions in my life, and according to the authority bestowed upon me, that every situation that is demanding for your people's God, Father, show yourself mightily unto their situations in the name of Jesus. Every power that have subjected your children to failure in the time past, today, I heard that God spoke once that all power belongs to God. I therefore decree that any power that is challenging your people's God, today, showcase yourself unto them in the name of Jesus, as you prove yourself on Mount Carmel. Prove yourself in the life of your people, as you prove yourself by the Red Sea. Prove yourself once again in the life of your people in the name of Jesus, that their life will never remain the same. When next we shall be meeting, there shall be a testimony galore in the name of Jesus. That particular womb that say fruit cannot be bear there, I command now, God of power, God of full restoration, will restore the womb that will be taken over in the name of Jesus. You that are carrying fibroid, I pray unto God Almighty, that fibroid that is growing in your belly, that people saw, thought that you are pregnant, I decree today, according to God of revelation, that fibroid shall be taken care of in the name of Jesus. When next you shall go to the toilet, you shall defecate the fibroid according to the word of God, or it melted out in the name of Jesus. I pray for you. God shall go ahead of you throughout this week. You shall be honored. You shall be elevated. You shall make it to the point of reverence in the name of Jesus. So shall it be in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. Amen and amen. I want to appreciate God Almighty for you, for believing in us that our God is alive and God is a faithful God. By the same time of next week, we are going to meet at the same station, the same hour. Remain blessed and remain rapturable in the Lord. God bless you all. I welcome every one of us. I appreciate you. God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.